The normal drug development process can take, you know, can take 10 years, and that can come from the ideation to of a molecule and understanding of the mechanism, going through a number of the proof of pharmacological plausibility. So that's really, you know, do we really think it might do something? And then moving into what we call the proof of hope stage, where you say, well, if it's for COVID, do we actually have some evidence that suggests that it will work against SARS-CoV-2? And then from there, you move into clinical trials to be able to validate some of those assumptions. You try to get the dose right. And so you're looking at from ideation to approval, it could take as long as 10 years. Hi, I'm Craig Rayner. I am a drug developer. I work in Certara. Certara is a global advisory company that supports pharmaceutical companies, not-for-profit companies, and biotechs in turning molecules into medicines. And from the Certara perspective, we have a lot of depth of experience in pandemic drug development, working in that space. And we're supporting more than 15 drug development programs across the world at the moment. We've also been part of the Gates Foundation Therapeutics Accelerator for COVID, where we're providing our strategic advice, our input into clinical trials and regulatory strategy. We really cover the full spectrum of the drug development pipeline, but probably our secret sauce is around using advanced mathematical methods to help us make better decisions in drug development, to go more efficiently and more cost effectively, to speed the access of medicines to patients. We work with all top tier pharma and many, many sort of mid-size and small biotech companies, as well as government not-for-profits and also life science investors. So in that capacity, we will be brought in to provide strategy. So what needs to be done next and where within the development plan? How does it need to be positioned for the regulators, and how can one articulate a very complex argument to be able to move a molecule to become regulatory approved? And then we also work in the stewardship space, which means not only do we outline the strategy, but we also sit with the development team partners, and help them along the way in making decisions and moving the medicine along its journey. So what drives me is the outcome and also the journey, because developing medicines is actually a team sport. This is not about ego, this is just about, you know, getting on and actually making a difference. And for me, the industry and the industry interface and working in those teams, there's just nothing to really say how fantastic it is.